Welcome to this next session of Harbor Engineering. We have been continuing with chapter number 2, that is Harbor Planning. In the previous sessions, we have studied up to the classification of harbor and ports. So now we will be continuing with the further topic. So let's begin. The first topic which we are going to study today is the harbor planning. So basically, this topic deals with whenever we are planning a harbor, new harbor, which sort of parameters we have to keep in mind. So let's begin with this new topic. For designing of harbor, the understanding of the working or the functioning of port, that is in which manner port or harbor is functioning, the functioning of port along with the needs of various users is essential. That is, the various users which are connected with the harbor or port, the stakeholders, all those things have to be kept in mind before planning a harbor. Ports should be planned taking into consideration safety and convenience of ships. So the ships which are likely to visit the harbor or which are to be handled at the harbor, we should make sure that whenever they are visiting the harbor, their safety should be taken care of, and also the operation whichever are to be carried out with reference to the ship should be convenient for cargo as well as for handling the passengers. Factors affecting the decision to build a harbor. So which are the various factors which we have to keep in mind while we are deciding or to construct a harbor. Need of harbor and the economic justification. First is, basically we have to make sure that the harbor is needed at that specific location or not. So that need should be first of all justified. Next is the economic justification, that is how much benefit is that harbor supposed to give to us, what is the cost of construction. So the benefit by cost ratio, benefit of each and every aspect, that is should be calculated in terms of monetary values, and what is the ultimate cost. So the benefit by cost ratio being greater than one, construction of that harbor will be justified. So how much feasible or viable that project is has to be kept in mind. Amount of trade or commerce by water transport. So what is the amount of cargo which will be basically handled at that harbor, and the commercial activities which will be being carried out at that harbor will be or should be kept in mind. Availability of inland communication. So what is the communication facilities at that specific location? That is, if we talk about roadway or railway, so providing a connection through roads or rails is easy or not at that specific location is a very important parameter as well. Need for harbor may arise from below stated condition, as we discussed in the previous slide, that first of all we have to make sure that there is actual need of an harbor at that location. So how we can make sure that the need of harbor exists? So for that, few parameters have been given. First is to serve an inland city which has grown and needs an outlet for foreign trade. So basically a city which has grown and which is capable for foreign trade, that sort of justifies a need for construction of a harbor. Next is the naval base needed for army or air base. So if there is a need for naval base, depending upon the protection or depending upon the defense scenario, harbor can be constructed. Required as a shipping terminal for product for which facilities are not available. So if there is need of a shipping terminal for the products and there is no such existence of facility where those products can be handled, then there is another parameter by which we can say that there is a need of construction of harbor at that specific location or in that region. Preliminary studies are necessary for preparation of site investigation program. So basically we have to prepare a site investigation program for the harbor planning purpose, and for that the studies have to be carried out. It should include the below mentioned information. So preliminary studies means the basic studies which are first and foremost needed. So what should those preliminary studies include? which will provide the data for planning of harbor. Hydrographic and topographic survey. Hydrographic survey, as we know, that harbor will be in constant contact with the water body. So various parameters such as depth, then we can have the data related to the tidal, we can say tidal forces, tide formation, regarding the currents, regarding the waves. So all that hydrographic data should be collected, that surveys to be carried out. Topographic survey, basically dealing with the landscape which is existing. So we will have the data regarding the features of the water body and the landscape, that is contours, what is the RL, what sort of the landscape is, that all data will be collecting. Subsoil investigation, basically the need for subsoil investigation is that ultimately if we talk about breakwater, which will be sustaining the forces of waves and wind, it will be transferring the load to the subsoil, that is beneath. So the subsoil investigation, we have to make sure that the subsoil will be able to handle that load, so that bearing capacity has to be studied at location of breakwater, as I gave an example right now, and piers or barbs. Now the piers or barbs that are the loading unloading platform will be ultimately transferring the load to the bottom. So again, we have to be aware about the bearing capacity of the soil. Direction and velocity of current at the specific location, as I told, that the we have to handle the current effect, we have to handle wind waves. So we have to be aware regarding what is the direction of the currents at that specific point and what is the velocity of the currents which we will be facing. So we have to be aware about these parameters. Important facts to be considered in the survey includes, firstly is the essential to carry out detailed survey of vicinity area including depth of water. Vicinity area means the nearby area, so we have to carry out detailed survey regarding the nearby area, and basically the depth of water is needed because, as we discussed, that talking about dredging, we have to maintain a minimum navigable depth. So we need the data, that is the important data regarding depth of water through which the ship will be moving in the harbor. Soundings basically means to measure the depth of the water. So should be made to get an idea about the extent of ground. To get idea of subsurface conditions, borings inland should be made. As we discussed that we need the subsoil data, we need to know the bearing capacity. So to get the subsurface, we need the sample of that subsurface of which we will be carrying out further tests, that is the geotechnical tests. So borings can be done for collecting the sample, which can aid in locating the harbor specifically. So it might be a possibility that a certain area might not be capable to handle the load, while if we move to the nearby area, to the vicinity, then it might be possible that we might be having a sort of certain soil which will be able to sustain that load, or where the bearing capacity is a bit better. So by carrying out the borings, by carrying out the tests on the soils which have been obtained through the borings, we can specifically decide the location of the harbor. Problem of silting and erosion has been discussed, so I will be moving to the next point. Sea insects causing undermining of foundations will be studied. So the undermining, which will sort of damage the foundations, can be caused by the sea insects. So we have to make the study regarding the sea insects, what is sort of the existence, how much is the existence of the sea insects, and how much damage can they likely cause. Meteorological phenomena such as the frequency of storms at a specific location, what is the frequency of storm, how much devastating can the storm be at that location, amount of rainfall, range of tides, that is what is the range of tide, range basically includes the difference between the highest level and the lowest level. So what is the range of tides, maximum and minimum temperature for the designing purpose at that location, direction and intensity of the wind, that is needed in the runway design also. But if we talk about the harbor, then at that, as we know that we have to dissipate the energy of wind, so we have to know the direction of wind and what is the intensity of wind. humidity at that location, direction and velocity of currents as well. What are the general principles of planning? So whenever we are getting out the planning of harbor, what are the general principles which we must keep in mind? Below mentioned are the guiding principles. First point is that the port or harbor should be divided into separate zones for varied categories of expected traffic, which includes cargo, grains, oils or passengers. Now basically, depending upon the cargo which is about to be handled, depending upon that, various bifurcations or various zones can be done for easy processing of cargo. Fishing should be located outside the ports area. So basically, the zone which is allocated for fishing purpose should be kept outside the port area. Adequate space should be allocated for cargo handling and storage, movement of heavy vehicles and equipment. So depending upon the cargo, heavy machineries and equipments will be needed, so that space should be available. Each berth should be designed for specific purpose as per the need and type of the cargo. So whenever we are designing or we are allocating the space for loading and unloading of cargo, we have to make sure that that is efficiently designed, that is each and every berth, each and every space is utilized up to the optimum value. There is no wastage of space. So that berth should also be designed keeping in mind what sort of cargo are we about to handle. So that has to be kept in mind. Specific berth should be planned for maximum efficiency. As I told you, efficiency is a very important word. So we have to make sure that optimum utilization of space is being done. Site selection for harbor. So the guiding factors which play a great role in choice of or in site selection of harbor are these various factors which play a role while selecting a harbor location. Availability of cheap land and construction material. So land which is cheap is a basic advantage. We are already aware about this point. It is applicable in our day-to-day life as well. Construction materials. Now we have to construct various marine structures. So the materials which will be needed for the construction of those marine structures, they are easily available, then that will be an advantage and will reduce the overall or the ultimate cost. Transportation and communication facilities, that is, it should be in connection with road transportation or rail transportation for moving of the cargo or commodities. Natural protection from wind and waves, if that is available through the existing landscape, that will reduce or eliminate the construction of artificial breakwater and ultimately reduce the cost of project as well. Industrial development, if it is existing in the locality, then that will aid in the construction, it will aid in the maintenance aspect of the harbor as well. Seabed subsoil and foundation conditions, if the seabed soil is such that it is capable to sustain load, it is having adequate bearing capacity, then that would be very fruitful while constructing the harbor, because ultimately the load of breakwater, load of the loading and unloading structures such as pier, wharf, quay will be transferred onto the subsoil. Traffic potentiality of harbor, how much amount of traffic could that harbor basically handle? So if it can handle more amount of traffic, the we can say sort of it would be advantageous rather than a harbor which will not be able to handle more amount of ship. Availability of electrical energy and fresh water, which is sort of we can say the most essential and daily needed commodities. What is the availability of these commodities? Favorable marine conditions, that is sort of the hydrological we can say condition or the topographical condition, are they favorable for construction of the marine structures? If yes, then that would be sort of we can say a plus point for that location for constructing the harbor. Next is the defense and strategic aspect. If you are talking about military harbor, then depending upon the topography, basically what is the height, what is the location with reference to the adjacent territory or the adjacent countries, that would be a strategical advantageous aspect. So if it is having sort of height which can help us while surveillance, then that would be an advantageous aspect for the military harbor.